workshop, which I learned from the Vice Chancellor of Nepal Open University, Professor Lekhnath Sharma. So when I heard about this workshop, I thought that this is a wonderful opportunity for our Tribhuvan University faculty to join this workshop so that they can learn how the online education works and the experience around the globe that you bring with your rich experience. So for the audience, Professor Ramesh Sharma is a very accomplished person in this area. He's been the director, executive director of several institutes in the past. And this is the space he has been working, information and communication technology in education. This is the space that he's been working for a long time. He looks very young, but he has a very long and diverse experience. So without any further ado, I would like to again welcome you with our big hearts and warm welcomes to the Nepalese community. And then I would like to request you to continue your workshop. And I think before that, Professor Sharma from Open University might have a few words.
Yes, yes.
Thank you.
Professor Sharma, your microphone is on. Please, you can speak now.
Lekhnath sir.
Hello.
Yes,
Lekhnath sir.
We can hear you perhaps.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
We can hear you. Please speak few words.
My system is not working.
It is working. We can listen. Please share a few words in the opening. Yes, we can hear you now clearly. Please go ahead.
Thank you very much. And first of all, I would like to welcome you all in this very grand session of this webinar. And first of all, I would like to pay my great respect to Professor Sharma, who managed time and then arrange such a meeting. And we are many people here, I think we are joining. And I don't know why my computer is not working, and I became in a very trouble right now. But I don't see my mic is working here, but my sound is going to you. So thank you very much for arranging all these things. And thank you, Ganga sir, for coordinating all university staffs. And then in next session also, in another time also, we'll get more contribution from Professor Sharma. So I would like to request Professor Sharma to continue your presentation and your whatever you would like to do regarding this, what online education is, how online education is possible using learning management system and other things, and how Moodle can be used for making everything, assignment as well as the record of the professors who are taking classes or not, and the student attendance and everything. So thank you very much for this arrangement. I'm very grateful to you, Professor Sharma. Thank you very much. I'll be joining with you.
Sure. Thank you. And again, Professor Ramesh Sharma, may I request all the participants to mute their microphone while Professor Sharma is speaking. And if he gives you space to ask questions, then only unmute your microphone. He will call your name or he will allow us to speak, then you can speak. Otherwise, mute your microphone so that everybody can hear Professor Sharma clearly and crisply. Over to you, Professor Sharma.
Thank you, Professor Sharma and Professor Gautam. I note that there are some colleagues whose screen name is showing as Lenovo, then NOU. So maybe you can rename yourself so that when this chat is saved later on, we can make out that in reality, who was in attendance at this time. So this way, let me now start sharing my screen. And I hope now you can see my web browser. Just if you can type yes in the chat box, then I will find that it is okay. Okay, good. So thank you very much. So my purpose today here is to proceed like this. And as VC Saab and Professor Gautam, he has very rightly told you that the significance of online education, and particularly not only due to this pandemic time, but even otherwise also, it is the need now that how we need to proceed it. And particularly like the Himalayan kingdom, you know, the far-flung areas, it is not easy to for the students to travel to the college or university or school, and then teachers to go there. So this electronic medium is a very big opportunity for us to use it in a big way. Now, when we go online, we need to prepare our lessons, we need to prepare our presentation, we need to do something which we will be putting online. And that brings a very serious issue of how we are using the medium, because then it will be seen by everyone. And please remember that copyright is a very serious issue. Normally what we do, we have to prepare any lesson, any content, e-content, then we go to the Google, search for something. Okay, I want to prepare for example something on a biology lesson, I want some photograph of leaf, I go there and this image is very good, let me take it, and I simply copy it, download it and paste it in my presentation. So that is not the right way. And particularly if unconsciously, if we are taking the copyright protected material of someone, please remember that the institution's reputation is at stake. So we need to be very careful that the personal reputation of the individual, of the faculty, of the teacher, as well as bigger than that, the reputation of the institution is very, very important. We should not do anything due to which our institution, it should come into the bad light. And that's why first, I want to show you the certain websites from where we can use their material legally. Means it is completely allowed. But before that, let me tell you a little bit about Creative Commons licenses. So say, these are the six kind of Creative Commons licenses. First of all, why they are needed? The problem arises that we have lot of all the textbooks, other journals, etc., which are copyright protected materials. And we as a teacher, we need to access them. But how do we access them? We need to either purchase the textbook or subscribe to the journal or something that goes there. But nowadays, the textbooks are going expensive. The libraries, they don't have that much of the budget. And particularly if the institution doesn't have big financial resources, it becomes a challenge to purchase the books or to subscribe to the journals. But as a teacher, we need the access, we need to access the material. So what should be done? And particularly if we are careful that we should not be violating the copyright license of some intellectual property of some organization or a person. In that case, then in the year 2001, Larry Lessig established the short of an NGO, non-profit organization. It is called as Creative Commons. And the Creative Commons, they suggested these six kind of licenses. The situation here is that the UNESCO in the year 2001 accepted the term open educational resources. It means these are those kind of resources which we can use openly. Openly means in terms of its access. So that makes it very easy. And here it just says that a copyright protected material, we need the permission of the publisher. I hope you understand it very well, that if you are referring to the textbook of someone, you need to have the permission to use that material. But here, the permission is already granted to you. So it means you can, if you find any resource on which any of these kind of licenses are available. At least the first thing is that you don't need to ask the owner or the publisher or the author of that work. That has already been granted. So we are saved in that way, that already the people, they are asking you, say, for example, let me show it to you. How does it look like? Say, this is my presentation, and here I have put this license. So it means anybody can use this presentation, and then they can download it. My another presentation, which I made, how to make. See, there is another license. So in that way, you give the license to your product, and then the people will know that yes, you can make use of that. You can download it, you can reuse it, and depending on the license, you can even modify that depending on. So very briefly, I will just first, the first one is CC BY. It means we need to just attribute, we need to tell that, okay, this matter, this content was created by this person, and that's all. After that, you are free to revise, redistribute, remix. Even you can make a commercial use of that. Suppose I wrote a essay and you liked it very much and you want to print it and sell it in the market, it's okay for you. CC BY. The second is CC BY Share Alike. SA stands for Share Alike. It means the new product which you create will have the same license. Otherwise, you can revise it, you can remix it, you can modify it, and so many things. The next one is CC BY NC. NC here stands for non-commercial. So anything on which there is an NC license, we cannot make a commercial use of that. We cannot sell that, but we can make a derivative out of that. We can revise that material. And then there is ND. ND stands for no derivative. No derivative means we cannot revise. I cannot change the material. Means, suppose if you find an you are creating a lesson on, say, photosynthesis, in which the plants, they have green pigment called as chlorophyll. Sunlight falls on chlorophyll, and then through chlorophyll, that is converted into carbohydrates, and the plants give us oxygen. This is the thing, Evan. And you want to use it in your work, but you think that the examples are given of Brazil, but we want to have the examples which are suitable for Nepal. So I need to change something. So if there is ND in that work, you won't be able to modify that work. So you need to find other work in which there is no ND sign into it. And that way you can use it. So this is just a brief there. I can have another session if you want to learn more about the open educational resources. And I am very happy that Professor Lekhnath Sharma, Vice Chancellor of Nepal Open University, they are already a member of Open Educational Resources University. It means that the products, the courses, are the training programs created by OERU, you can now freely use them. If they have created a course, and if you think that those course will be good for the students of Nepal, you can just take down all the material and start offering that course in your institution. They won't ask for any money or any hindrance into it. You just use all that material and start that course at your institution, and you can award the degrees. So that is the beauty. You don't need to spend 6 months, 1 hour in creating a course for you. Already, if the course is created by someone else, and if it is shared with you, you just go ahead and use that. So that is the power. Now, when we create the one of the functions for you, now in this time is, let me divide it into this way. First of all, you need to create e-content. सबसे पहले आपके पास material होना चाहिए, तभी आप उसको आगे पढ़ा पाएंगे. So you need to have the e-content with you. And to how to create e-content, where you need to see the resources from that is very important. Don't use copyright protected material in your work if you have not obtained it through proper means. means if you have purchased the book, even then you are using it not for further use. You have purchased that book for your reading pleasure only, like that. So creation of e-content. The second is to teach that. For teaching that, you need two things. One, a certain sort of a platform, which we call it learning management system, on which you will be putting your content material. So the learning management system, for example, NOU is using Moodle, which is one of the top rated, the best open source learning management system. And the second is an online medium through which you can teach your students. Like now, we are online face to face with each other, and we are talking now. You can ask questions, I can reply to those questions, you can type the questions, I can type my. So it is in real time, the real time communication. The next thing is assessment purpose, evaluation of students. Formative assessment and summative assessment. Formative assessment is during the tenure of the duration of the course, that how the student is learning, we need to find that. And summative assessment is done at the end of the semester, end of the year, wherever you think that now the course has been completed and we need to have the examination of the students. So online examination, and Moodle serves the purpose of everything. You can configure your Moodle in such a way that it will allow you what you were doing in your class as such. You can do it completely through that platform in online medium. So with this, the initial background about it, how we need to create e-content, I wanted to show you this very important information about Creative Commons licenses. Now, I am recording this session, but still you can, if you want, you can keep writing in your notepad there. So first of all, I will show you the places from where we can search copyright free images. And there are certain websites which I use personally in most of my presentations. And just now I was showing you, say for example, here is my page. And let me show you one of my presentation, say this one. I was the keynote speaker in Turkey in this conference just a few months ago. And if you see, if I have used any image from extra source, I have given it citation. See here, you can see it, it is there. This is my own university. Here I have used it, this website, and I have quoted it. Here is the image, I have quoted it. This is our book, my book on e-learning. This is from Television Grab. Here you can see the image and its source. So the main thing is that for your presentations, we need a lot of graphics. And if we just take any graphic, it may be not a good idea to use just any website. So there are certain proper websites which we should use it. So one is Unsplash. You can see, read it here. It is internet source of freely usable images. And you can search from here various things, like very recently nowadays we are talking of COVID-19. So if you want to search some images related to that for your students to teach them that how to remain safe in COVID. So you can see that in particular way, they are there. So you can think that, oh, okay, this image is good, I can use it. And like that, so you have found, you can find for nature. Yes, I will make available the recording of this session after this. So we have nature, we have wallpaper, texture, pattern, people, business, travel, technology, animals. Many things are it has a very big resource, big database on. So you think that, okay, you want to use this image, you simply click on it and this image will be there. You see here, it is written download for free, and then maybe you can share this image with others because you are allowed to share it. And if you want to see its more information, then you can see about that it has been downloaded only this month, and so far it has so many million, 2 million views. This image, it was shot by this Canon. These are the certain informations and the dimensions which you can use. and when you download it, it will open, and here it will save it in your disk, so you can download this image. And here it gives you the link also that how you can cite this image. Just copy this and paste it in your presentation. It's very simple. So this website is called as Unsplash. You can use it very well, and it has millions of images on various things. You can and if you are kind enough, you would like to share your things with others, you can create your ID and you can submit your photograph from here. So this is one site. Another site is Pixabay. So this is, you can see over around 2 million high quality images shared by talented community. And you can find image means photograph, vector graphics, illustrations, videos. There are many things available on this website. And you can say, okay, the images are divided into two categories, the raster image and vector image. You know, sometimes if you zoom out, you expand an image, it starts getting pixelated. वो उसका क्वालिटी खराब होने लग जाएगा, उसमें डॉट डॉट आने लग जाएंगे. दीज आर कॉल्ड एज द पिक्सल्स. एनी इमेज इज मेड ऑफ पिक्सल. सिमिलरली यू सी योर मोबाइल फोन, यू से दैट इट इज 14 MP मेगा पिक्सल, एंड फॉर योर टेलीविजन इट इज 4K मीन्स 4000K. the मोर डेंस द पिक्सल्स दे आर, द बेटर क्वालिटी ऑफ द इमेज वुड बी. सो द नंबर शुड बी लार्ज for a better quality of image. But if you are making a use of that photograph for online purpose, please remember that use a small resolution, otherwise you won't be able to upload it on a website, you won't be able to send it by email to your colleagues, to your students, something like that. And if you are using any image for, say, offline purpose, so for example you want to take the photograph of this mountain or any of this photograph, and you want to make a banner of that, then better use a high resolution photograph, because that will come in print, it will look much better. So that is the difference in that. And it is always better to use three formats you should prefer: JPG, PNG portable network graphics, and TIFF. TIFF, these formats, they are always better for online there, and use them. Somebody is asking that how you can change on your screen. When you find in the upper corner an icon, there you can click, right click on it, and it will ask you to rename yourself. You can change your name from there, or you can just quit and then log in. And when you log in, then it may ask you to give your name, so that way you can do. So now, say for example, here if we are searching for, say, economics, I want to prepare some lesson in economics, and there are certain images which I think that, okay, for economics, what I want to show, okay, I want to show this image that how the agricultural economics is here. This photograph is very good, I want to use it. So see here, the beauty on the right, free download. So it allows you to free download. And here is the license. See the kindness of the people. It is free for commercial use. So if I want to use this photograph, make a banner out of it and go to the market and sell it, perfectly all right. Commercial use we can make. And the second thing is that even the person says, who is the author? Here is the person who has created. And if you can see, already this person has contributed 2500 images already on this platform. So here they says that even if you don't want to cite, it's okay. So here no attribution required. So you click on any image, you can search, there is a lot of thing. And about this particular image, here are the dimensions, this is the resolution. This picture was created on 3rd April, very recently. It was uploaded just few days ago, and it has been downloaded already by these many times. So it gives you an idea that how this thing, it works. Next site is fotter.com. This is again, you see, there are so many things. 335 million free stock images. So it means it has a wonderful thing, and you can see you can sort them by category. If you want to find such something for education, interiors, technology, people, sports, nature, food, anything, or you can search it by ID also. Means you are not sure, but you know that you want to show something related to home improvement, or it has a lot of ideas into it as to give you some help accordingly, then you can make. So let us see, if I want to search something for, say, blockchain technology. So here it will show me the pictures, and okay, I think that this photograph will be good for me. Okay, I will go with this image. It shows me that how I can use my mobile phone for this. So this website has some other characteristics that if you want to use this, see how. First, it shows you that how you can get this image. So from small up to the extra, extra large, its dimension, it will be very big when you download it. So good for banner, the large size. Either you can download it or you can embed it. Embedding means in your website, in your LMS, it is allowed. You can embed it. Embedding means it will just display it there. Giving a URL means you are sending your user to some other option outside your area. But here, you are able to embed it. So these two things, and then second, license. So here it is no derivatives. It means you commercial use is okay, you can sell this, but you cannot change this. Now how do you change it? Here suppose, for example, if you want that along with this mobile phone in the photo, you want to put a book here. So it means you will be modifying this image. That is not allowed in this particular case. There are other images where you can find it. And then here is the its attribution. If you means it says attribution required, you just copy it and paste it in your thing, and that will be okay in this case. Let us see another example in which we don't have the issue. Say, for example, I want to search some information on lion, and there are so many photographs which I found. Say I like this photograph, I will click on it, and see here the license is changed now, and here says that modifications okay. So I can change this photograph now. Depending on the background, I see this green jungle. What I can do, I can add a photograph of the cub of the lion here to show them that the lion is with the family, or I can add a tree, or I can add some meat piece that the lion is eating something that way. So you can, modifications are allowed on that. So this is this website called as Fotter. Let me show you one more that is called as flickr.com. This Flickr website is purchased by, it is owned by Yahoo now, and it has a very good resource of millions. You can say here, see, home of 10 of billion of photographs, means tens of billions of photographs, such a huge database it has, and you can search many, many things on this website, and all they say that start for free. So for example, if you are preparing some lesson on virus, you just put your term there, virus, and it will show you all the images wherever the virus is there. So you see, everything is there. Now we need to think here, click on any license. And from here, we can see that what kind of license we want, which image we can use. I want that I want to use an image which I can little bit modify for my purpose also. So here, or all Creative Commons, anything it will show me, and accordingly when I click it, it will show me only the Creative Commons licenses. Now Another specialty of this website here is I can search an image with a particular color also. Say I want to show danger, that virus is a dangerous thing. And then red is the color of danger. I can click here on the red, and now it will show me the images mostly where the red color is dominant. So you can see the red color is dominant in all these photographs. And then I can see that which image is good for me to use. Then I can have the, these are called as the patterns, means I can search something I can use as the background image for my work and like that. So this way we can use it. Normally you all use Google search engine. Google search engine has become very powerful. Sometimes, let me tell you some cases. Long back, I remember that I gave a presentation on examination system. And I had used a photograph there of to show that how bad our examination system is. What the examination system is currently, we have all kind of students in our class, intelligent, average, poor students, but we give them a common question paper. 5 questions, attempt all the questions, and then it is the examination is same. So I want to find that photograph again, because I have to, and I don't remember that where, on which website I saw that image from where I took it. I need that photo again. So what I will do, I will go to the website, say Google search, and I will type few words like examination. I know that there was tree in that photograph, and there were some animals in that photograph. Just these 3 words I remember, and I will click on it, and you see it has shown me the photographs. Let me enlarge it so that you can understand that what that image was. And here you can see what it says, that for a fair selection, everybody has to take the same exam. Please climb that tree. This is a satire on our examination system, that monkey can climb the tree, it is okay, but how the elephant will climb, how the fish will climb, how the seal will climb. But the teacher is saying that all the, to the students, take this examination, and though who will do this, they will be declared as pass. So that way it's a thing. So, but I can use the net to search something for me. Let me show you another example. I remember that once I was giving a presentation on the power of internet, and the internet has become very, very powerful, so that it has so many things that it becomes difficult for us to select that which information is good for us. And I remember that there was a slide in which there was a fire hydrant into it. So what I will do here in Google, I will type fire hydrant. It was yellow in color, so I will tell the computer yellow, and then there was a mention of internet on it. Let's just see that if it can show me that image. Here it is, you can see, and you can see that and here if you see, this image is from Flickr. It is showing you Flickr, Twitter, and getting information of the internet is like taking a drink from a fire hydrant. You know how difficult it is if you start drinking water from like tube well or fire hydrant. You will get wet because so much of the water will come to us. We need only little bit that way. So these are the things here we can use the power of Google. Another important aspect here of the Google search engine is to use its advanced search engine. So here either I type advanced search engine there, or when I'm somewhere, I use the, go to the settings. For example, if I type here leaf, and I want to search some images of the leaf, but not every leaf here, say like this image is from Britannia.com, this image. And Britannia is, it is written here, images may be subject to copyright because it is Britannia.com. It is the published house from the company there. So the images will be copyright protected, but we don't want anything. We want open source images. So what we will do, the search is still there. I will go to settings. I will go to advanced search. And here is my keyword. Now, those of you who are from science, mathematics, computer science, you may be knowing that there is a word we call it as Boolean. Let me type it here. B-O-O-L-E-A-N, Boolean. Boolean means and, or, not, these kind of things. So what does it indicate? If I type that Nepal and Rudraksh, and here means both, so it will return me those search engines in which Nepal and Rudraksh, they both word will be there. If I say Nepal or Rudraksh, it will show me the results in which either the Nepal is there or Rudraksh is there, either of the two. If I say Nepal, not Rudraksh, so it will show me the results on Nepal, but it will eliminate those results in which Rudraksh is mentioned. So that way you can define your search. So these are the extra power of internet. But here, after making your thing, you can decide about the size, large size, small size, and you can decide a color, any color, full color, background, transparent, this, or you can select a color, and you can type any region. If you want any leaf of a particular country, it can help you in that. And then here is the last one, the usage right, which you will be using. Free to use, free to share, free to commercially, free to modify, whatever you want. You click on that and use the advanced search. So it will show you here. And here you can see the first image is from Wikimedia. Wikimedia is a free to use it. Wikipedia, Pingming, Pixabay, I showed it to you. All these images you can very well freely, safely use them in your work. Here, no copyright problem for you. See, such a beautiful resource, means so many photographs available there, and you can use them for, means you can search for anything here. And here you see this is has come labeled for non-commercial year use with modification. So this particular image which you have selected, you can modify them and you can make a use for you, but not for commercial use of them, like that. And that way you can see its type, a time, wherever you want to search, you can use them. Nayan is asking, what about Wikipedia? The Wikipedia is an example of open sharing. So any entry on Wikipedia, say for example, this image is from Wikipedia. You can see here, you can very well use it. Just give the site the source. Say for example, if I go on this page, and here all the examples are there. This is all about these resources. And if you go to the bottom of the page here, you will say that the Wikipedia, these are text is available under Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike licenses. And similarly for the image, if there is any image, you can click on that and the image will be opened. And you can read the here, you can see more details, CC BY SA. It means you can, if you click on it, it will tell you what is the definition of this. It means that you are free to share it and to adapt it. It means you can remix, you can build upon any purpose, even commercially use this. So that is the advantage of Wikipedia. I also use most of my PowerPoints either text, even I take text from there, and images or resources from Wikipedia, because it allows me. I just take care that I cite the source of that page. Particularly if I'm using it, I'll simply copy it from here, or even it allows you, that is the thing of it, that even it suggests you that how to cite. It gives you a ready-made citation about using it. You can simply copy this sentence here, and that will make it citation of its source, so that you can very easily use it. So this was about the images which you heavily used for your course. Now let's go to video, because video is very important and you may find some good videos which you want to use in your classroom. But any video, and particularly what is the most common source for videos? We search for YouTube. So we go to YouTube, but please remember that any video on YouTube is not allowing you to download it, because it may be with a standard YouTube license. It may be with a standard YouTube license. For example, say this video is on yoga. Let us see what kind of license this video has. So this is the video. Below that, here is the category, and there is no mention of license. So if there is no mentions, in the absence of license, please remember that if there is no mention of Creative Commons license, it means it is copyright protected. Without permission, we cannot use it. So what do we do? Now what we will do here, say for example, on the same topic, if I want to search something on yoga, I will put my there, and these are the results displayed. But still, it may or may not be a copyright protected image. So let us see any image, maybe like if we want to see this one, let us open that and see if it is copyright protected or not. Okay, so this is the image and this is the video. Let us play this video. And here is that video. And here is the description, show more. Here. So it means this video is copyright protected. What we should do now? So we will do this. Come here. Okay, let me just stop this video. Here. Okay. So please remember, see this filter button. You need to click this filter button, and here, this is the hidden treasure of YouTube. You can search for when the video was uploaded, if you know that about its time. वो कौन सी टाइप का वीडियो है, वीडियो है या चैनल है या प्लेलिस्ट है या मूवी है या शो है, टेलीविजन शो, जैसे वो छोटा वीडियो है या बड़ा वीडियो है. एंड हेयर इज क्रिएटिव कॉमन्स. यू कैन फाइंड 360 डिग्री 3D वीडियो, लोकेशन बेस्ड वीडियो. इफ यू वांट टू सर्च समथिंग फॉर काठमांडू लोकेटेड, यू कैन हैव ए लोकेशन बेस्ड वीडियो, और मुंबई का कुछ देखना है ऐसे करके. वो सब टाइटल्स मीन्स जो आवाज है, द स्पीकर इज स्पीकिंग, इट इज कमिंग विद द टेक्स्ट ऑन द स्क्रीन, दैट इज सब टाइटल्स. सो हेयर इज क्रिएटिव कॉमन्स, वी विल क्लिक ऑन इट. एंड नाउ ऑल दीज वीडियोज दे विल कम, दे विल बी विद ए ओपन लाइसेंस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, यू मे बी नोइंग अबाउट बाबा रामदेव, ही इज ए वेरी फेमस पर्सन हु इज प्रोमोटिंग योगा एंड अबाउट प्राणायाम, अनुलोम विलोम, दोज थिंग्स. So you can click on that video, and here you can show these are the things available and category. Here it says that non-profit and activism. So it means you can use this video for your non-profit, non-commercial activity like that. And you can search for many of this, the same thing you can use it. So this is how you can use YouTube and search only those things which are with, say, I use Photosynthesis, and here is the filter. It comes, I go to Creative Commons, and these are the results which is allowing us. I click on a video, and if I go here in the description, here you can see the license, Creative Commons, reuse allowed. So you are free to use this presentation, video, for your own classroom lecture. That way you can use it. There is another resource for you to search for videos is how to download YouTube video. Bharat is asking. Okay, that is a simple thing. We will tell you two things. First, let me show you this teacher tube. This is the teacher tube page. Click on that. And this is a free community for, you can search the lessons for science, mathematics, history, social studies, language arts, and in, including educational songs. And you can type here, say, okay, the page is coming up. You can type for, say, algebra. And here you can see there are so many things, whatever you want to search for that. So that will come on algebra and the video will appear. Here are the videos. And in fact, you can search the audio also. For, on this topic, there is no audio, but the videos are available. And you can click on them and then you can use them. So here, if you click on it, it will show you that video which you can download from their website. That way you can go it. Now another resource is which is very good on science subjects, that is called as MIT Blossoms. This is MIT Blossoms. Here you can say this is math and science video lessons, and if you go to the bottom of the page, you see here it is written blended learning, open source science or mathematics studies, and so many languages are there, English, Chinese, Japanese, Portuguese, and so many languages. You can see here you can click on any topic which you want. And here is the power of exponentials, big or small. And here is these are the instructors, Swati Gupta, John, and Natalie. The beauty of this website is what I like it. See, language. So this particular video is available in English, Malay subtitles, which is spoken in Malaysia, Spanish, Mandarin, which is Chinese, and even Urdu. So many languages this video is available. You can download this video in various formats. And not only this website gives you the transcript either as PDF or MS Word. So if you think there is anything good for you, even you can use the transcript, because transcript is sometimes very good for students who sometimes are not able to hear it clearly, or right, they don't understand the language of the person speaking, but they can read it from there, and that makes it a good resource. So this is for there. Now let's see if we say again photosynthesis and how to download the video. We go to the video and you can say in this video you want to use it. So you go to that particular video, and then what you do here, the simple way is, what I do is the simple way is, before Y of YouTube, you just add double S, like super saver or speed saver, double S, and press enter. You can download this SaveNet form also if you want. But here, this video has come. And from here, you can decide that you want the MP4 in 360 format, which is little small in size, or 720, which is a high resolution. And you can select it, and then you can click on download. And then see here, I can save it, I can open it, and it will be saved in my computer. From there, I can use it. Okay, so this is about the videos. Now the videos are created by someone else. Suppose if you are creating your video, if you are creating your presentation, and you want some music in the background with that video, so from where you can search. And remember, for music if you have some party, some marriage, some birthday celebration, we just play a song there. Within our house, it is okay, but not for main functions, like if it is a big marriage hall and there we are playing, because all the music is released by the particular industry with those phonic there, the act there, and it prohibits us from unauthorized display or playing that music. So there are certain websites from where we can get them. One is SoundCloud. You can use it from there. So this is one SoundCloud. You can search, and you can search their database. You can explore what are the trending playlists, and then it can show you the stream, the library, and if you like anything, then it has, means it is available even as a mobile app also, which you can use. And if you think that there is something good for you, you can use them for your work. Another website is called as Free Sound. Here you can see that it is a collaborative database of Creative Commons licensed sounds for music and sound lovers. So let us see this website, Free Sound. Here the Free Sound, you can search sounds and see here it is written. It is a big database. You can browse, you can download, you can share the sound from there. You can click on it and you can see Strong Wind. If you think that it is okay for you, you can click and it will play. And here you can see this is licensed under attribution license. This is the format, this is the duration, this is the size, and it is a stereo sound like that. So that way you can check and use this a website. Another one is Jamendo Music. So here is the Jamendo site. You can see it is free streaming, free use. It allows you. So here you can see the free download of various kinds, which you think good for you, you can use it. You can explore it later. Okay. So this was all about multimedia. Now what about the text? From where you can find a good text? So one of the resource is, say, like Athabasca University Press. This is Canada's first open access press. And you can see that all the books and journals are in open access. And I would suggest Professor Sharma also to download some books, and Professor Gautam, because you are going for online. Let me show you, there are some wonderful books on online learning, online teaching, and you can use them. Say like Online Distance Education, Emerging Technologies in Distance Education. Okay, let us see this book. And then Issues in Distance Education. Theory, this book I wanted to recommend you very highly. These theories, those of you from distance education, you may be knowing Dr. Terry Anderson. He's a wonderful person. And this book of his has been translated into more than 60 languages around the world. More than 60 languages. You can simply download the print, the soft copy. But if you want to buy a print copy, they charge very nominal, the processing charges of sending it by post to you like that. But otherwise, this download is free of cost. And if you want to go into the online, you can read all this table of content. And here you can see it may be reproduced for non-commercial purpose. Just don't print it and sell it on the market of 100 rupees. Otherwise, for your students, download it, print it, and give it to everyone. Terry Anderson, Athabasca University Press, don't have any objection of that. There are these further books, Mobile Learning, Learning in Virtual Worlds, Emergence on Innovation in Digital Learning. wonderful book and free, officially allowed you to use it. Even you can take one chapter and you can edit that chapter and use it for you. The Emerging Technology by George Wallestinios. So that way, this is the book. You can use it for your purpose. The another one is OpenStax. I'm showing you from where you can download the textbooks. So here you can see the subjects: mathematics, science, social science, humanities, business essentials, high school, college level, university level. What? Say I want to search something for, you can see here, these are peer reviewed books, openly licensed, 100% free. They won't ask you, and they are simple to adopt and free to use. Simply just get it. Say, for example, here is a book on history. And here is the table of content, and you can download a free copy. You can just make use of in going into their search engine, and from there you can locate what is good for you. There is another project. It is called as Open Textbook Project of Hong Kong. Here is the open textbook. So see, this is primary school, secondary school, certificate, diploma level, or university textbooks. And they have very good books. You can just download that book as such. Say like communication theory. If someone of you is teaching communication theory, you can use it. Literacy, literature, and see here is the, you are allowed. Oh, so I said, say for example, business, accountancy. This is free open textbook for tertiary level. Feel free to use, adopt. Even you can modify the content to your own needs and share the content with others, because the book was offered under Creative Commons license. You simply download the PDF, or even if you want to go online, you can see the online book from here and tell your student that this is the online resource. If you want, you can read it. So the book will be opening here now shortly in front of you, and you can read it online. You can read it on your mobile phone, and like that you can go completely free. No copyright issue. Don't do plagiarism. Don't, there is no need for cheating anyone. And like that, it offers you a fantastic resource. Okay. So I think I have told you a good number of resources. I will stop here for a few minutes so that I can see the questions, or if there are something, and then you can ask me. Let me a little bit scroll up. Okay, Bedjit Singh, may I request you to record? Yes, the lesson, the session is being recorded. Okay. How to change my name? I think you have done it already. Okay. Please, something of coronavirus. What about Wikipedia? I already replied to that. Okay. Any questions so far? Okay, then I can proceed. Now I will show you a little orientation about the learning management system, the Moodle, and then I will request my, yes, now let's move to the LMS, and then I will request my colleague to make a presentation on how we can use certain Parveen. In the meantime, if you are hearing me, can you post the link so that in the meantime, those of our friends here from Nepal, if they are using their mobile phone, they can download that app actually. Can you just type that into the chat box?
Sir, I'm just sending the link.
Yes, okay. In the meantime, I will change my screen. please have a keep a look in the chat box in your systems. And in the meantime, I will go to learning management system. I will open some of the websites which I am associated with. So Dr. Parveen has posted a link in the chat box. Okay, let me see if there is any question. Okay, so those of you who are using your Android phone, kindly click on it and install the app. And those who are using iPhone, they can go to the App Store and get that app, so that because just after a few minutes, once I explain it to you, then I will we will show you how to use the app, that particular tool for online assessment also. Now, learning management system, say this is our Ambedkar University Delhi learning management portal. We have two portals available with us. This is our previous one, in which we have many our all the courses, more than 150 courses. They are available on this, and we use it for various purposes, even for feedback, for project work, for on the job training work, as a normal course offering something. These are, and this is our updated, this site is our updated latest version of Moodle, on which I am creating some of the courses. Say like on Indian tourism, mental health, because in coronavirus now the mental health is one of a serious issue. This augmented reality, ICT level 1, level 2. These two courses are for the Delhi government teachers. And blockchain in education, developing self-learning materials, etc., etc. These courses. So, and then I want to show you this one. Here, this website, we have configured it in such a way that it has two instances, English as well as Hindi. So the language pack that can also be installed on your system, so that you can have, if that pack is available. So here, if we select it, it means the students of ours, you can see it now, the things inside it, they will be in Hindi. You can see them accordingly from there. So what is Moodle? This is the official website of Moodle, which you must, I will suggest you two of the websites, moodle.org and moodle.net. Moodle.org, this website is to check all kind of documentation related to its installation or something. It's a good website, those of you, for you to learn about how to use Moodle. Say, manage your course, how to set up your course, how to add students, track progress, how to add activities, what are the features of the Moodle mobile app, how to manage your website, how to get started, everything is there. The second is downloads. And remember, Moodle is open source. We don't pay anything to anyone. So, and 3.8.2 is the latest version, and Martin Dugiamas is a good friend of mine. Very recently we were talking. In fact, today only on my Facebook page, I had posted a link by Martin that the version 4 is coming next year. And for that, they are asking the community to suggest that how the, and can go back to search, yes, how the Moodle should be. They are asking the teachers. So please, you can go to my Facebook page, and then maybe you can see that link. This is my Facebook page. You can see me with my name, Ramesh Sharma, over there. And it will show you that Moodle link into it. That's a good thing that it will allow you that how you can means you would want the Moodle to be in the future. So the good thing about it is that it is available on various platforms. You can install Moodle on your pen drive, USB drive. You can install Moodle on your laptop. You can install it on your desktop, on your mobile phone as mobile app. So many platforms are available wherever, and its mobile app works wonderfully. It allows you to access your material offline also when you don't have the internet connection. Once your students, they download the app, they browse your course, and after that, if they don't have the internet, they can still browse except the streaming media like videos. For that, definitely David. But the text, they can access it even remaining offline. So this moodle.org, please. And second is this moodle.net. This is a platform for you to learn from others or to help others to how to manage Moodle for that. So if you have any questions, you can come here. If you want to tell others about your knowledge, you can also join them for their work. Like that way, it has so many of the information, and you can download the source code if you know the programming and modify. You can see here all these libraries, shared products, archived products, and everything is there. So you can. That's why it is called as open source, because it gives you the code on how you can use it from there. So now, how do we use Moodle? Let me show it to you. Say I will go to lms.aud. Okay, I will log in to my account. So this is the interface for my account, and we go to site administration, or I go to list of my courses, and this is the area. It depends on your role that how you can make it. At present, I'm in my manager role, but we can switch our role to various other capacities like manager, course creator, teacher, and like that. So when you have that administration, like the administrative role, administrator role is like the vice chancellor of the university, very powerful. They can manage everything within that system. The second next powerful role is the role of the manager. You can consider this role as the registrar of the university. Registrar is also very senior position, very serious position, very important position like that. Not that much powerful as vice chancellor is, but still very powerful. So can do many things. Course creator, you can create a course and you can manage all the activities. So these are the roles in decreasing order of authentication of power, what you can do within that course. So that way we can see that how you are asking, you are managing your users on your website. So here you add a, by clicking, going to the course menu. The two thing important for you here: handling the users and handling the courses. They are the main things for you. So you add a new, you click on add a new course, and here you give the full name like introduction to biology, and a short name. Short name is needed for this. This is called as navigation. Whatever name you will give, it will be appearing here in the navigation path. So that's why you should try to keep it short. Like I can write bio, or at least biology to make it distinction, but not that full name. And then I need to tell that where I will be putting this. This is called as category. Category, you can think of it like say Almira, and in Almira you have various shelves. So one shelf is like undergraduate, all these things will go there. Another shelf is like postgraduate, you put the things there. So, and it depends on you. You can create as many categories as you think the university is offering. So it will go there. course visibility, whether it should be visible to the students or hidden to the students when you are creating it, depending what is the start date, what is the end date. That is the power of it. You don't need to do it manually. You can tell the computer that the course will start on 7th April at, say, 1 a.m. and it will close at 3 a.m. on 27th April next year automatically. Before that, you can't see. After that, you can't see. So that way, it is highly secure. Here comes a little bit the course summary, like this course deals with and whatever you want to put it there. And here is the course image, any image which you would like to come in your course. Say, for example, if I can add some image which will fit this course. So I will add it here. The image has come. Now, this is these two, three things are important here. One is the course format. Moodle allows us to organize our course in four ways. The last two, topic and weekly format, they are nearly same. Like if I'm teaching, say, parts of a flowering plant. So I can have it in weekly format. In week one, we will study stem, week two, root, week three, fruit, week four, flower, like that. Or topics, root, stem, flower, leaf, but otherwise they are the, in a way, similar structure. Then single activity format. Suppose you are creating a course on coronavirus and you have developed 10 videos. First, short videos. First, you told that what is a virus. Second, what is coronavirus. Third, what are various types of viruses. Fourth, from where this coronavirus originated. The fifth, next is what is being done in Nepal to control this coronavirus, like that. And you have created only the videos for your course. In that case, you use it as a single activity. That will be better, because then it will arrange them in a sequence manner. And when the student goes through the one, it will open the next one, and next one, and next one, and like that. Social format is something like where you have it in a discussion format way, that there is one question, the students, they contribute to that, they have the discussion on it, and everything is visible from there, and that you can go ahead with that. This is to increase or decrease the number of sections. And here, if you want to show them all on one page or one section on one page, it is your choice. So this is the formatting. How does this course will open? So by normally we keep it. This is good for you to understand file upload. It depends on, in our university, we have a lot of space. So we can allow students to upload even up to 500 MB. But it is always good to keep it a little low, like say like 2 MB or at the most 5 MB. The reason being, if you allow the students, they will upload anything, and then your server space may start filling up very fast. So keep it in that way, that at least the students, they also need that bandwidth to upload it on the servers. And then completion tracking is very good if you want to understand the learning of the students, the learning analytics purpose. You can make it no, you can make it yes, and that way, the rest are the okay. So you can click on save and display, and your course will be created. So this is the course, Introduction to Biology. Let's see how at present here it is asking us, there are no students into it. How do we enroll students? Enroll the students in your course. First, they need to exist in the database. So the first step here is to put them, to add them into our database. Once these students are in database, then we can enroll them in various courses. So you need to add the students. We will show how to add, but first how to enroll. So you click on enroll students. Is there any suggestions on this side of PPT? I could not read it. So here the selection, the role, you can add any person in this course as either as a manager, as a teacher, non-editing teacher, or as a student. By default, it is thinking that we will add students, so the role is here student. And then you can search some students, say like here I can, from here I can add anyone. I can add any student into it, and simply if there are more, okay, Otherwise, I will click on enroll users. And now as you can see, there is one participant. Here is that participant. And I can see the participant has come that way. And now I can proceed for course content. I can click this way similarly. And the process which I have showed you is to add one student at one time. But you can upload cohort, a whole group of students. Suppose you have 5,000 students and you want to add them in one go. That is added as cohort. So you upload the cohort and then select them in your course. So now this is the draft structure of the course. But first, let's see how that course is looking like. Here is the course, Introduction to Biology, the photograph which we uploaded. And when we go to our dashboard or there, depending on the what kind of settings you have done, it will display the information about that course. So you click on it and you come inside your course. Now, this is that topics format. I can simply convert it I can type it anything. For making changes into our course, we need to click on this gear icon in the upper right corner. And this is called as course management. You can see you can take a backup of the course, you can restore a course, you can import it for thing, and you can do other things from the more course management and about the users. And you can track, you can have the gradebook set up for examination purposes because it is fully automated. Most of the activities we can make it in such a way that the software will take care of everything. So we need to turn editing on. At present, you see it is all plain, but now you will see these other things like pencil ka icon aa gaya, add an activity aa gaya idhar, ye char muha wala sign aa gaya. This is to, now it is very easy. We can rename them. Say here I will study about root. Here I will study about stem. You just type it and press enter. Leaf, flower, like that. Just simply rename it. And then you think that okay, the leaf should go up, so you can rearrange them, and that way you can just simply drag and drop and it will change its position. That's super easy. Now here comes the real power of it, to add an activity or a resource. So these are the activities. You can see there are many things which we have activated on our Moodle platform, and here are the resources which we can add. So I will show it to you very shortly. First, I think now, okay, let me see some, if there are some questions. If there is any suggestion for the site of PPT presentation slide, you can see. So, okay. What we will do now, I will continue with it. But before that, no, I will stop my screen. In the meantime, those of you who have been using Moodle, if you have any questions, you can keep your questions ready. Otherwise, I want to request Dr. Parveen Sharma to share his screen and let us have to look on the result of an online assessment activity. Okay, Dr. Parveen, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, because this will give a break because there is a request to take a short break. So yes. In the meantime, quickly, very quickly, those of you who want to do some short break can go and come back again. Okay, Parveen, over to you.
Okay, sir. Namaste, everyone. Good afternoon to you all. We are going to talk about one thing, which is about online assessment that you can use at your university and which works well with the higher education students. And the second thing that we will be working on, if we have got enough time, we work on podcasting. Some of you must have heard it and some of you must not have done it. So we'll be working on podcasting as well.
And before I start, I'm just willing to ask you, if you people have installed the application, you can just drop a yes. The application was, the link was shared with you. I have reshared the links. QUIZIZZ. This is the link, which is there, you can see in the chat box. And I'll be sharing the screen also.
Those of you who are using mobile browser, they can simply go to this website. You for on computer PC, you don't need to download the app.
Yes, you can link on you can click on that link also if you want, and you can install the application later, like after we have seen the working of this resource. You can click on the link, still it will work fine. If you have installed the application, after installing, it will ask you for a game code. Wait for it just after the break, which is there for a few minutes. We will start the game thing also. I will be sharing with you a game code, and through that game code, you will play. And when you will play those two small quizzes, you will get to know the use and the features of it. So we hope that you will be impressed by that thing. And then we will share with you how we can use this application. So, sir, I have displayed my screen, and I suppose it is visible now. The quiz is here.
No, it is gray screen.
Okay. Is there again the same thing that we happened yesterday? Like I have to take the host thing, or I should go?
Just try. Let me see if I can make you presenter. Okay. All right.
Let me try sharing something, sir. Wait. What I'll do, I'll try to share the complete thing, like the full content, if I can share, if the people give this possibility. Sir, is it visible now?
Yes, it is visible. Yes, very good. The benefit is that now it will come into the recording.
So what I did,
there will be no break in recording.
Yes, I have opted for screen one, so that way it has come.
Okay.
Now I can also see it on my mobile phone.
Yes.
Right, sir. So I'm waiting for the responses in the chat, and I believe all.
Yeah, they say yes. They are saying yes.
Done, sir. So they have installed it. Very nice. And if you have like not installed it, not a problem. Still, the link is there. quizzes.com/join. It will work for you. So just let me know when I can start. I guess the screen is properly visible, I suppose.
Yeah, we can see Hubber.
Okay, people have asked demanding the game code. Yes. First, we will be playing a game on COVID awareness, and second game will be something which is going to be very difficult for you. So the first is easy because we all are facing. The second one, you will understand when the link will come to you. First, there's a COVID awareness quiz. What I'm doing is, and just doing a final check from the chat. Yes, we have got many of them. Sir, the moment you'll say okay, I will be sending the game code.
Okay, you start.
Okay, now my screen is going to display a game code, dear friends. Now see, if you look at the screen, you can see that I have brought something for you, which is a COVID awareness quiz, 10 questions, and the interface shows you there is a button called team, classic, and test. So what I'm doing is I'm going the classic way, which says individual participation. If I would have clicked on team, it means like teams will be formed, and you will become a part of team, and then the game will be played. This website, this portal, QUIZIZZ, gives the possibility of hiding the names of the participants. No one will come to know who scored less and who scored more. Only the team score will be displayed to each and everyone. So this is team, this is classic, this is test.
Classic means individual participation. Test means you can give the test, but it is not live. They can do it at their own, but still it will be seen by you. And team is, we can form a team. Sir, I want to go the team way first.
Okay.
And we have got the participants that we have is, like, let's make teams which are, I'm making six teams now. I have taken, number of teams will be six. And please remember, once the game starts in the team, you cannot join late. In the individual one, anyone who has the code can join before the game ends. But now when we are playing with the team thing, it means you cannot join this once this competition starts. You will not need to name yourself. The machine will give you fun generated, funny sort of interesting names. And if you people have seen Kaun Banega Crorepati, Amitabh Bachchan's mega show, you must remember there were some lifelines. So this application will also bring you some power-ups, which are called lifelines. Some options will be coming like 50-50, then erase the wrong, and then you won't lose even if you give a wrong answer. The timer I have disabled. I'm going to apply shuffle questions, shuffle answers. Both the things will be shuffling. And the other thing that I have done is you will be getting a redemption question at the end. So we won't do redemption and memes here. So here we go to continue. And see, everyone, this is the game code for a team match. This is a match in which you are going to be divided in six different teams. The code is 630642. I'm dropping it to the chat also. The code is 630. Sir has already done this. 630642. Very nice. So people have started joining and they are getting divided into teams. If you people are not able to install the application, the link is there. You can click on quizzes.com join, and there also you can enter the same code. Now we are not able to see the names of, you can see this. Names of participants are not seen. You have got a funny name. So when you people are going to play it individually, I request you to change your name. Otherwise, these names will remain. So we have got six teams, 4+2. In two teams, we have got two players. British bunnies, brave chickens, hurtling turtles, soaring penguins, Ted Rexes, and airy elephants. So teams are forming. When we'll get four members in each team, we'll start the game so that we can save time to demonstrate how we can use it. This demonstration will be coming to you through a recording. So there also you can see this is a team feature. You can form teams in your class and then students can play these games. Good. Still, we are waiting for more people to join. Quizzes is a website plus smartphone application based thing. Before we like start playing and explaining the features, one feature should be known to us. It really works better with the browser. So you can be the teacher organizer of these quizzes that I am going to host for you through the desktop version only. Through the mobile phone application, you can challenge them. But this thing that you are able to see now, where you can see the team names, you are able to see there is a start button. I can see 14 participants are there. These things will not be there. So please remember, there are two players, three players, three players, two and two and two. There are six teams only. So any number of players can be there. Good. We are able to get 3+2. And there is one interesting feature. Suppose we start the game now and there is one team which has got two players. Another team has got three players. So disadvantage you will see. There is a disadvantage that way, which is there now. But still, the quizzes app or the portal, this website gives you the feature. Those who have less players will get bonus points. So I play with two players, you play with three players. So I get an advantage. It will be giving me some extra marks for that thing. Sir, should we start? or people are still joining? Okay, now they are joining. I guess the break is now.
I think we can do it now. The team is equal.
Okay, now sir, there is one interesting feature in it. Like, there are so many things that a teacher wants to control when you are conducting these assessments in the class. Suppose I feel that first day people have joined the teams and now they people know, like, this is something na ki, oh, hey, tum kaun si team mein ho? Hey friend, you are in which team? So they get to know by the elbow talks. They push the elbow to the other person and say in which team you are, and they get to know that we are in the same team. Any moment you can click here on the shuffle teams, and you click here and now see your teams are shuffling. Now you have I have changed your teams also. So this can also happen when you people have allowed them to pick their real names. What I decided that I want to hide your original name. So if the real names are there and you see there are some people who should not be there in one team because they are very intelligent, or it will be a mismatch between intelligent and slow learners that way. Now we are starting with it. Only one team has got different players. So what we can do, there is one participant, Apple Artemis, who is just extra one in one, making it four, otherwise all are three. We are starting the game. Those who have joined, they will play, and those who have not joined, they will keep looking at the screen. How the game is being played, we will see it live.
You will see a question and some options, so please select them. Sometimes there may be more than one correct answer also.
So now teams are jumping. This is a natural procedure of playing the games. You have already played so many quizzes in your life. So once you see the questions, the human brain is very intelligent. You see the problems and you start searching for solutions.
And it has some provision for music also.
Yes, sir. Very good. I'm just pausing the music only. The class accuracy at present is 63%. 27 right answers and 18 wrong answers have been given so far. But no one knows. The students do not know who's giving the right answer, who's giving the wrong answer, so that they will not fight later that you failed us. So the team remains a team. Very nice. But still you have got only 1 minute, everyone. Within 1 minute, I'm going to stop this game. I will be clicking on end game and the game will stop. So be quick. Brave chickens, what are you doing? You must have seen the feature that you cannot join late, even if you know the code. Generally, the code appears on the top when it is an individual game, but because it is a team game, so the code is not working now. Sir, I'm willing to end the game because they have already seen the interface of this quiz. There were only 7 questions and we are taking time because we are playing it for the first time. The same interface works on the website also and the application also. The music plays, you can unmute and mute the music. So I am ending the game, everyone. Just checking out the chat if it is there. I have 3 members. Don't worry, sir. If you have 3 members, you are getting more score. The same way we used to play cricket in our childhood. We had 7 players, the other team had 11 players. They would say that 2 of your players can play twice, even if they get out, or the target will be shortened to like 100 runs will be made 80 for us. So ending the game, and because I'm ending the game, I'm requesting everyone, Dr. Nayan Kumar Prasad, you have not seen the question. If you were playing, then please share the screenshot why this happened. We are ending the game and I want everyone, please look at the screen, how the results will be displayed or the prize distribution will happen.
And imagine the excitement of the students when this thing will come on the projector or the smart screen of your class. Ending the game, you will not be able to answer now. Here it is. So the winners are: third prize goes to Soaring Penguins, second goes to British Bunnies, and the first one is Airy Elephants. So this is the result we have got. I'm putting it in with us on WhatsApp. After the session, I'll also share this image with you. So, sir, this is one thing that I have shown. This was about the team. Now, see, these are the names, Fava, Finch, and these were the names which were given to you. I can email all parents. The reports can be sent to all parents. I'll click here. It will ask for email IDs of the parents, and then I can send the report. I can send individual reports also. These are the scores. This is what, like, whosoever was Fava Finch answered the question wrong, that what is the meaning of social distancing, and the time was 11 seconds. Fava Finch answered the question right within 8 seconds. If you cannot wash your hands with soap and water, use sanitizer. True or wrong? You answered within 8 seconds. So if you are very quick, even then you get extra marks. If you keep the correct questions streak continued, you get extra marks. So I'm exiting now. If you see, I'm going to reports on my account. I have made an account on it. You can also make an account. See, the quiz that we played is COVID awareness quiz. 19 people played, and it was a team, as you can see. I'm opening the report, and you will see. Now, this is the report of all my participants. Lentin Lorex and Cilentro Chestrin could not play. There must be some reason you logged in and then you stopped or something. Other people have participated somehow. And then I can print the results. I can download the results as an Excel sheet, a CSV file. I can print it. It looks very good when the prints are there. This report can be printed by you and you can keep it in the files. Sir, is it visible, the print preview?
Yes.
This is the print preview, everyone. COVID awareness quiz. And suppose this is being played by you and you feel, no, this was COVID awareness, I want it to be renamed. So what I'm doing is Nepal Open University and Tribhuvan University 26 April quiz. I can rename the report. The quiz is not to be renamed. So again, I'm clicking on print, clicking on this, and then I'll show you. Now the review is showing the name quizzes, NOUNTU. This is the report, you can see. Very good. I'm really happy to meet those who tried to solve the equation. Very nice. So, good answer. I'm closing it. This is the report, everyone. I can send email to the parents. So, parents or guardian or anyone, I can send email to all the parents. Now, the score can be sorted into this ways. Score through accuracy. First name and last name of the student. So this can also help you, because generally now we get roll numbers through alphabetical things. This is, I can view the same quiz. These things I request you, you explore it yourself. I can find which question troubled them more. Now you can see this. Social distancing, stay away from others, was said by 53. Unattempted by 4 players. So which question did this thing? Now there are certain questions also. Now let us go to the difficult quiz I was talking. Now it will be played as an individual quiz. Now now again, another code is coming your way. We are playing classic. The setting is how many times a student can take this quiz. If I say one, it means you have to make an account. Today I am making it unlimited, because even if you do not have an account, you can still play with it. And do you want to show the answers during the game? I'll say no, just validate. Do not tell them the correct answer. I'll say no. Tell them the correct answer. It will also appear. If you go wrong, this will come on your screen. Show the answers post game. These are another settings. Show them the leaderboard. So leaderboard, now you will see who is going to the top. After every question, you will get to know on what rank you are.
Okay.
These things are happening. And here is the code for the most difficult quiz for all of you. Please do not make your mic unmute. Keep it mute, because the questions will be changing their sequence. Now see, Fava Finch, you did not change your name. I request everyone to change their name when you are participating. I'm removing this player.
Okay, we'll keep you. We'll change your name later. Not a problem. 419-419-491. And we need maximum participation in this quiz. Because we have got 50 participants, so I'm expecting at least 40 participants in this. Everybody who's there in Nepal, in different parts of the country, we request you. 9 players now. This is individual, 1 player game, and I'm sure that you will also be getting prizes once the lockdown ends. We can make a provision of prize to the winners of this quiz. The results will be there with us. The reports will also be shared with you. Just one more minute and please join. You can join later also, please don't worry. Sir, if you allow me, I can start because anybody who has the code can join anytime before the quiz ends.
Okay, just give them 10-15 seconds and after that you can start.
Done, sir. And after playing the quiz, we request you to share your comments about this quiz also, because we have made this quiz specially for you, a very tough one, just to connect in a better way with you, and you'll feel happy about the quiz also. We think so. Oh, good. 18 is the number now. The participants are 18. This quiz, this is also a link. You can see joinmyquiz.com. This is also there. joinmyquiz.com can also be used, or quizzes.com/join can also be used. You can type your query if someone has got a query. Quizzes application, if you have installed, the game code is on the screen. If you do not have the game code, you can go to joinmyquiz.com or you can go to, now see this thing, there is a button called share. So I can click here and I can share this thing with Google Classroom, Schoology, Twitter, Microsoft Teams, Remind and Canvas. So these platforms are supported by them. You can, like, this thing can be learned later because it will require a bit of time. You can use this platform with the Google Classroom or Canvas or these other platforms which are mentioned. I can copy the link. If I paste the link here, now you can click on this link and certainly you will be there. 21 participants, sir. I wish all the participants allow me to start.
Yes, we can start now.
So everyone, here we go. Krishna ji, BRN, very good. More participants. So 25, I'll start. 24 now. So just one person and we'll start. Yes, here it is. I'm starting with this now. Enjoy the game. Do tell us the correct answers. You can join. Keep joining. The code is 419-491. 419-491. It's very nice. Good. Now, some of you who are not playing can see the screen of this session also. Very good. Someone typed the code as the name 46069 is on the top. Good. Dheeraj Sharma is again on the top. 46069 on the top again. LOPC rank 3. Baba Finch is on 5. Good. Kanaya Gupta ji on 7. Good performance. So Kiran ji on 7 now, changing. Very good. I'm playing the music so that it remains with you. Very nice.
When your screen has gone off,
I'm just starting it again, sir. I guess it is come now.
Coming up. Yes.
Yes, sir. Be quick. We are not giving you much time on it. 10 questions only, and very difficult for all of you. We can understand. Bahut mushkil hai aapke liye ye wale prashan. Good. Not really. मुश्किल नहीं रहे होंगे.
Nice. So the moment we'll see that five people have completed, because participant Dr. Ganga, you have about to complete it. So the moment five participants complete the temptation, we'll consider the time is over. If you all allow us, I have got an option that when the dashboard is there, I can click on top five. So only top five will be shown to me, or I can click on show every participant. I can see all the there are a few participants like some people have got names. What I'm doing is Binod Shahji and some more, I'm removing you so that you can join again. Or if you suppose you are not able to join, you can change your name, because once the name is entered into this website, so it will say that you are already there. So what I have done, some people had not started, we have removed them. Now the number of participants is 24, but accuracy is 83, good performance. So we are about to end it now. Sir, should we?
Okay, I think
we are ending the game, everyone.
Yeah, we can do it now.
Okay, it is done, and I want everyone to look at the screen of the presenter. Please come back to the screen, stop participating so that you can see the results. Be quick to come to the screen to see who is the winner. You know this, but you don't know at the last moment who answered the question correctly, who hit a sixer. So here it is. Now, the reason is the names were not changed, so you are finding these names only. So now we are going to move on to see. You have seen, it's a beautiful description or a presentation of the results. We can play the quiz again. Now see, I can tell you the performance of the quiz. Meanwhile, I request you to put your observations about the quiz in the chat box. The class accuracy, everyone, is 72%. The first question was, select the correct, and then you answered it incorrectly by 14 out of 24. Toughest question is this, correct statements. There were multiple statements. You need to see when there is a checkbox type of thing, there's a rectangle that way, then you need to select multiple. So you must have missed it because you used it for the first time. So there are two things which are correct in it. Then longest question was in which you people have said, write three favorite words, open-ended question. So people took 71 seconds. Average time was 71 seconds. So these are the words that you people have written, 333 words, whatever you wanted, you have written. There were no marks of it. So one question had accuracy of less than 40%. This is the question. Where is Nepal Open University located? We took it as like you might have opted for a wrong answer. So this was correct. Let me find out which one is. 14 incorrect with select the correct statements. Kathmandu is the capital of Nepal. Nepal is located to the south of India. No, today is 26th of April, but it is not Saturday. The website of NOU is nou.edu.net. So this was a checkbox thing. Two answers were correct. Now, sir, I am exiting it, or I can download the results from here also just after playing the game. Overview is here. If you people can see, the report of all the players is here. Like if we can see the names, SS is here. So now here it is. So exit. And we come to the main portal. You make an account, please. Once you have made an account, you click here, find a quiz. You type here your subject, BIOLOGY, suppose. Because we are more concerned with science subjects and engineering, that the content will not be found. So these are the quizzes which are already there. You can simply click on any quiz. You can click on play live, and then you can play the quiz the way I played the quiz that I had made, team, classic, and test. So we'll get back just to like show you. Suppose this is a quiz called MATHS. You can search it the way you want to search it. You can save it in your collection. You can like it, or you can click on more, and then you can use these settings to search question. That number of questions is this, most relevant, most played. Another thing is, we'll straight away go to create quizzes,
And before that, if you have got queries, you can put them in the chat boxes. This is the last thing to be shared in the quizzes thing that I'm sharing with you. You click on create quiz and you get this thing. Name, you will say NOUNTU test quiz. You select a particular subject if the subject is there, and then you move on to next. You name the quiz, select the category. I can select an image. I can rename it. I can make it public or private. If it is made private, only you can play. Other people will not see it in the public. But I am making it private because we will be keeping it as a test only. I click on multiple choice. This is the multiple choice. If you, those who are teaching physics or mathematics or anything in which equations are required, now see, you click here, wherever, like you see the question statement, you click here, and this is all you need to make those equations that you saw in the quiz you had played. And even in the options also, you can give the same thing. In the options, you can click on media when you, and you can drop an image. Suppose you put an image and then you say identify this person and then you give the name there, or you can record an audio. If you have heard that audio, which is one of the most famous songs in Nepal, now you can click here and you can record it within 2, 3, 1 second. Which platform is shared with you today that you are learning? Saved. It is uploading here, and now you see it has come here. Suppose I write here, quizzes, I write here Gmail, and then I write other things. This is the correct. I click here, I give it a time, and I save it. Now see, this is the thing. This is how children will play a new question, and these are the options that you need to explore. Poll and open-ended, there is no marks. There are no marks for it. Fill in the blanks will have marks. Checkbox will have mark. You click on teleport. Now you type your subject here. Suppose I'm making something on COVID and I press search. I'll get all the quizzes made by other people. I click here on this quiz at the center on the screen. All these questions will come. I'll keep on clicking add, and this question will go to my quiz basket, and these questions are getting added by default. I'll say okay, isme se ho gaya, done from this. I'll move to another one. I'll say okay, I'll take this, then I'll move on to this. The COVID quiz that you played, I used some of the quizzes here, and then I ported the questions. I imported the questions to me, that they, you import them and you bring. See, these are the questions in your quiz. You can click edit and do change them, otherwise not a problem. I say done. It will say language is English. I say yes. Grade, I'll say from grade 4 to university level or professional development. It is private, yes. I'll say save, and the moment I save everyone, my quiz is going to be ready to be hosted. Now you see, this is play live. We have played. Assign as homework. You can set a deadline. Suppose I say I'm setting a deadline for April 30th. Time is there. Continue. And then there is a code. You give the code to the students and they will do it. This is how it happens. And I'm showing you the reports now. The third thing after homework was giving them a practice link. So assigned, it means it was a homework that you people just saw. Running it is because I had clicked on it and it is still open. I'm just deleting it to remove it from the reports. This is the report page that I have. I have been using this platform, so all the reports are from the classes. This is the assignment which was assigned to them, and I gave them 3 days, and the deadline was 3 hours ago. So for the last 3 days, these people were submitting, and these are the results. I can click on download, and it will give me a MS sheet. Spreadsheet will come. It will be downloaded by me, and then I can see it. So this Excel sheet is there that you will be downloading, and then you can use it in your files also. Now about this resource, if you got some queries, you can share. Classes, you can add Google Classroom classes here, like these classes I have added, and you can send assignments right from the quizzes application to the Google Classroom. These are the quizzes I have made, and these are the collections that I have, like made by others, but I have kept them the same way you make a playlist on YouTube. So this is quizzes. you create a new quiz. Please remember, from the smartphone application, you can challenge your friends, but you cannot be the teacher who's hosting it, and it will not be showing on the projector screen. So a desktop is suggested to make it better. So this is what I'm sharing with you. Quizzes is the thing. So if there is anything that you people want to ask, or if sir wants to explain something, then I will be pleased sharing the answer.
I think you have explained everything. And about teleporting.
Teleporting, sir, we have shared, like any quiz. Suppose I take this quiz, I'm just rewinding the tape now. I go and edit. Please remember, if you want to make my quiz your quiz, so you simply open the quiz and click on edit and save it. It goes, it becomes your quiz. But again, this is not a good thing that you steal the material of everyone. So this is the quiz. I have already clicked on edit. I'm going to teleport. The moment I go to teleport, the title of my quiz has been taken automatically by quizzes. So it has searched everything. But see, because this title is something which will not get me anything. Suppose I want here NEPAL. I'll say I'm making a quiz on Nepal. So any quiz which has got the word Nepal should come. So here it is. You can see there are things about Nepal earthquake also. There are things about our country, Nepal. So I see this title looks fine. So these are the questions, everyone. They say, oh, good. Which is the following is the Nepalese Devanagari script? I'll say, ye wala achha hai. This looks good. And then they say, Nepalese celebrate festival of colors, which is also known as, I'll say, ye bhi, this is good. And this is how, like, I'll say, now what is this? This is shown as this. I'll say, altogether, how many mountain peaks are opened for climbing in Nepal? So this is 326. And this is how the quiz is already being there. I'm just taking this thing from others. There is no way at present to add the Creative Commons or copyrights or something. But if someone has already kept their quiz public, it is public. If you are, I'm keeping it private, it is private. Only those who have the link, they can play. Only those who have got the, I mean, code, they can play. I can change public to private anytime. Suppose I changed it. It's about sir said, this is a toggle switch, as I learned from sir. So it is done. All these questions are there in my quiz now. You can see. These are the questions which have come. You can see this fest about things about Nepal, they have come. So these are the things which are there. If you have got anything to say, you can please ask. Once you will start exploring it, you will learn it. If there will be any issue, you can still contact us. Privacy, Dr. Kishore, I shared with you, you can keep them private. But let's have a big heart and share things with everyone. In the title, you can put, like, I have made it NOU and TU quiz. Let me, like, this is the only way that I can share. I'll be writing to the quizzes team about the Creative Commons and something, and that allow us to put the licenses also, because we want to clarify that we are not keeping the copyrights. Let me make it CC BY. I'll make it 4.0. Sir, I'm writing it correct this way? Like, this is how we write about the licenses?
Yes, that is correct way.
So this is how I've written it. Let me save it. Now, this way is we are suggesting to ourselves. Now, we can develop it. Like, just today, while talking to you, I got this idea. So I'm changing all my quizzes with this thing in the brackets. So that I'm spreading the Creative Commons awareness.
But that has to be done only for the questions either we create or which are already CC BY by someone else or in public domain.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes,
now
sir.
You can take up with that podcast. Then I will
okay.
Go ahead with
but I will be taking less time with it. Suppose, like, what I'm doing, everyone, I'm opening another tab for you and I'm going to start playing something. And this will be in Hindi, and we all, like, we share almost the same culture that way. So I took help of one of my students who's from Janakpur Dham. I was sharing with him the music, the audios I was listening, and then I shared with him the questions I had prepared just to check whether I've written it correctly. So I hope that you people have liked it. Now see, this is the audio which is coming.
सवाल उठा रहे हैं हेलो दिस इज धीरज फ्रॉम जनकपुर
डन सर ये आप सुन रहे हैं दिस इज अ पॉडकास्ट एन ऑडियो टेलीकास्ट ऑन यूट्यूब वी शेयर वीडियोस एंड ऑन इन पॉडकास्टिंग वी डू दिस थिंग इफ यू हैव हर्ड अबाउट बाबा आमटे आई गॉट टू इंटरव्यू देम इन वन ऑफ द प्रोग्राम्स वेयर वी हैड वेंट अ चिल्ड्रन लिटरेचर फेस्टिवल सो आई रिकॉर्डेड द होल ऑडियो एडिटेड इट properly and then placed it here so you can listen to it I used the music from a site where it was a creative commons thing like they had allowed the reuse but I have still kept the link like background music Vaishnav Jan to Taine Kahiye and this is the link to that source so this is how we can put audio lectures or interviews And this is the talk, and this way there are so many things.
Pardon, I think the audio is not coming.
Audio is not there. So I have shared the link to the channel also. I suppose.
Yes, they can click on their device and then can listen. Yes.
Yes, sir. Because okay, I'm using the computer audio. So this is one thing. This is learning radio's thing. What I have done is I have taken this feed from here. This is the RSS feed. Some of you who are familiar with the computer terminology, I'm a faculty of communication skills in English, and this much I learned only because it was not my domain. But still, this is the RSS feed. I took it. I went to another website, which is Hubhopper Studio. I gave my stream to them, and then that thing created my podcast channel on Hubhopper as well. So these are the same things, if you see. And what we had done, like these, this is not the promotion that I'm doing for myself. Like you see, I'm moving on to the basic thing, the first one. Like my students who had some stories in their text. So what I told them, I said, let us do one thing. You record the audios of your chapters, the story chapters, and we will upload them. So like you can see, A Cup of Tea by Catherine Mansfield is a story. In graduation, it was there. And I knew that people want to listen or watch things these days and not to read. So I said, you keep the text in front of your eyes and then keep earphones in your head. I got recording from the students. I edited them through Audacity, which is an audio editing software, which is an open source. Now this is being played and I can share, I can download it as an MP3. This one, A Cup of Tea, was recorded by an MBBS student. So every student who's in your literary club, you have got students participating in cultural events, they can be like guided to help you in this. Audiobooks are the culture of the day. These days, the trend is of audiobooks and reading books as on Kindle or as ebooks. So this is one thing, learning radio, how you can do it, like how this can be done by you also. So I'm sharing with you, if you can see, the Podbean app is there. The link is here. I'm posting the link for everyone. This application, and I'll be sharing with you a short video. Sir, is there a possibility that like we can send them that audio through WhatsApp or something?
Yes, I will send it to Professor Lekhnath and he can distribute, and Professor Gautam, they can distribute sure, it further. So that's
sure,
okay.
Sure, sir. Because that will allow me, like, I'm not sure whether, because yesterday the screen sharing created some problem. I'm trying to share the screen, if it is possible, like, of my mobile phone. This is from my side. Podcasting you can do. You can use this thing. The moment you make an account on it, it will be possible for you to see. It is very easy, my dear friends, very easy. You install the application. There is a red mic button. You click on it. Recording starts. Recording starts, and then what you do is you record it and then you simply save it, change the name from date to the name, and then you upload it, and it's easy. So if there is any problem, like what I'm doing is I am typing my email for you. If there is any trouble, you can drop the email to me, and you can also contact sir first for this thing. So this is podcasting. Sir, I'm stopping the share of this and just trying if I can bring the screen from my mobile phone if it comes.
Okay, sure.
I'm just trying, sir. Got it. There was one setting which was stopping me from doing this thing. Now it is going to come, sir.
Everyone, start now. Yes, sir. My mobile screen is visible, everyone?
Yeah, it is coming up. Yes.
I have unmuted myself as well. Now, sir, now see, I'm opening Podbean. And now see, this is Podbean application opening for all of you. And just keep a close watch on the steps. It will allow me to save the time also. You can see this red button at the bottom. I'm clicking on this red button. Even if something comes, you can see it will be the home page of my file. There are some options on the top. Some icons are there. The icon which has got a human shape is your account. So I am clicking. These are the things which are already there. If I click on this icon, this is the page that I have. I've got 695 plays and 22 followers are there. So what I do, I come to the home screen. I click here on the red button. Now see, there are two options. One is record the audio or start live cast. So these two options are there. You can see them now. I'm recording the audio. You can even go live. You can explore it once you have established your channel here. So I'm recording the audio. I'm clicking it here. See, then this interface is there. I can click on country. It means this music will be playing. Effects are there. Effect means I can make an effect of clapping. I can. These are pre-saved things in it. I can change the tone, speed. I can change the music also. There are music pieces here which can be taken by you, and then if you like it, it will become your background score. So, and only three can be kept on the home screen. So I have kept this one, which is here. I say, so we go this way. Today, when we are talking about, is being paused and the interface is like not overlapping with it. I'll say save. File data is being saved because, just a second now, I'll go this way. Recording through the microphone is on and then it is being recorded because I'm using multiple microphones, so there is some trouble with it. Otherwise, it works very fine. We save it and then the screen comes for you. Or you. Stopped. Saved. Valid format is that is a trouble because of I'm plugging and unplugging the phone. So once you are done with this thing, once you like you record it and you click on save, this is what it becomes. These are your drafts, and it will be posted only when, like, if it is, it will be posted only when you click on this arrow. And when you click on this arrow, it will ask you to change the image. Every podcast can have its own image. You can give a description. You can name the episode also. And then you can post it. It will go to public. And then this will appear as something that can be shared with everyone. So, like, these are the episodes that you can see. All the episodes that I have prepared, the students have also prepared them. These are here. You can make your students RJs. You can make them anything through this thing, sir. Sir, these are the things. I'm stopping this thing now.
Okay, thank you, Parveen.
Yes, sir.
Thank you so much. It was a good presentation. Any questions if someone wants to learn about podcast or how we can use interactive quizzes? Otherwise, now I will continue with the Moodle. Okay, here are we for our Moodle course, which we created prior. And as you know that now in Moodle, we can add these many things. It depends on your instance that what you can have. For example, here in our case, we have something, few things extra than the normal Moodle, like this custom certificate. This is an extra plugin which we can add to our Moodle so that once the course is completed by a particular student, this custom certificate will generate a certificate as a PDF and the students can download it. Similarly, here you can see Hot Potato Quiz is a plugin for making interactive quiz. There are 5-6 types of quiz which we can create using Hot Potato. And then there is this interactive content item H5P, which is open source, and we can use it. In fact, on our Moodle, we had Turnitin plugin also to check plagiarism, and it was just now we are having Urkund also, Urkund, Urkund, which is another software for plagiarism detection there. And this questionnaire, this is another plugin questionnaire which we have added to make the questions a type to conduct an online examination for the students. So these are the activities where the students, they have to interact. And this big blue button, it is an open source web conferencing tool in real time to talk to the students. Like now we are using WebEx. You must have heard about Zoom. There is Skype. Similarly, there is big blue button, which is open source in nature. And nowadays, even the moodlecloud.com, the company, it has integrated this big blue button by default. So you can anytime by installing it here as in plugin, it gives you advantage that you can schedule your class and then you can save the recording there within your class area. In moodlecloud.com, you can schedule your class, but it won't save the recording from there. So let me first go with these resources. They are quite simple. For example, if you are using a URL, you want to tell your students about some URL. So you go, and URL means any website, external website, which you want to give. So here, suppose I will give you the name as Nepal Open University, and the URL I will search for Nepal Open University. The website will come out here, and I will copy the link. We'll go back here, paste it, and then if I want to say something, appearance means how it will look, how will it appear, automatic or in a open in a new site or in a pop-up and or in embedding there. So you can make it like open anywhere and these settings, and then save and display. So how it will look like, say you go to your course, and here is this, from the icon you can see that this is a web page. So you click on it and it will take you to the that site of the URL where that was indicated into it. So that is a URL. Next, we can add page. So you click on page. Okay, someone is asking how to access Urkund or Turnitin. You need to have two things for that. One, the plugin here. You can install the plugin. Actually, the administrator of your website, they can install the plugin. Let me show it to you from where we do it. For that, you need to go to site administration. And in site administration here, you see there are plugins. And the plugins overview means what you have. And if you want to install a new plugin, you have to click on install new plugin. And then from here, you can see how to manage and antivirus plugins are there. Then you can make an authentication. So what, and then what you can do is that, if you remember, I showed it to you, the various the site of Moodle.org, and here you can search for plugins. So what kind of plugin you would like to search, you can check it from there. Say if you want to search for Turnitin, and then you from there you can search the, you need to install the plugins from there, and once you have added the plugin, then you need to add it, and then it will be visible in your course area. So that way means there is an API for that, but you need to have the subscription, means install the software on your server. So on one hand you have your Moodle, on one hand your software like Ukund or Turnitin on your server, and through API you join them, and the plugin acts as a bridge between these two. So those kind of plugins which are available, you can show them. Like here you can see all these plugins activity, it shows you here around. There are so many are available. You can check for their updates, and there are some extra. You can add them, you can enable them, you can uninstall them. If you find anything which is not okay for you, which is something, assignment, feedback, book, custom certificate, about images, about databases, it's about this hot potato, etc. So long list. So that way you need to configure them for your course. What is the question? My sound is uninterrupted. Okay, maybe sometimes the internet is slow, or in that sometimes it happens. Let me come back to our course. So here was how. Now, how to add page. So this is the page I will add. Page is a short of an information on which the students will be reading something, and the page can hold anything. So I can write here like flower, and description, it's a short of a summary which you, or means you can, or you can avoid, it is not compulsory. But here comes the text. So you can simply say like you can copy paste some text like that, it has come. And if you think that you want to add some image from here, you can add by inserting image. You click here, browse repository, you can upload a file, you can select, and you can add some file into your course and upload it. The file has come here, and you can save this image. So look, the image has come. And similarly, you can make any thing as a hyperlink by making the hyperlink here and creating a link for that, and that will become as a hyperlink. You bring it and it will take you to that particular website. There is one interesting thing here, is to create, like Dr. Parveen showed you podcast. The Moodle also allows you to create postcards. Here is this microphone button. You simply click on it to record your RTC. Oh, it is saying that my RTC, because I think I'm running two, three applications. So I need to click something there, but you can try it from there, and you can add something extra from there. And then you click on it and save and display. So this is the page how it will look like. But in addition to that, we can add a video to our course. For example, let me close this one and go here. So I'll go on site home, and here is the test course. I'll click on turn editing on and say I want to add an activity, and here is the label. The label is a very good property here. It allows us to see the things as they are exactly on the screen. So what I can do here, suppose I want to show some video, Photosynthesis to the students, and I find a video. Suppose I find this video as a very good, useful for my work. And here is the share button. I click on share. This is the URL for my video, but I will take the embedding code. This is the embedding code. I will copy this. I can fix the time also, that at what time it should start. This function is good when you suppose you have copied a TED talk, which is around 1 hour long, but the material reference which you want to show comes at 25 minutes later. So you can make it as what time the video should start on in your page. You are not cutting any video, the video will remain the same, but on your page it will start from that point where it has been mentioned here. So you copy it, then you can close it, and you come here, you find the HTML code for it, and you copy as the HTML editor, you update the page, and then the video comes, and you can save and return. Now there is a difference. Now this, if you use the label, it will be directly visible here as such, and you can click on it to find that it works. So that way it works. The difference between now these two functions is a different one, that if you put anything into the page, I can put this video into the page also. Let me show it to you. I will create a page now, and here is the page. I can say here is a page on plant, and here is my details. I will add it. I'll click on it. I will update it. You can see the video has come here again, and I'll say so. Let me go back. Now see, there are these two things. This I created using label. It is directly visible. But here is a page. Page is like as a page in the book. Say for example, this is a book and these are the pages. It is something similar. And to see it, I will click on the page, and then it would open, and here I can see. So I can add anything, my text, my audio, my video, anything multimedia in a page. That way it can go. Then another interesting activity and resource which we can add to our course, which I use quite a lot, the upper three: a book, a file, and a folder. So let me first make the explain you what is a file. A file is any kind of document which we can add to our course. For example, if I'm adding a course, I click on it, adding a file. So it is telling me, say, like I'm adding something related to plant. And here it is asking me you can drag drop files. Files means more than one. Files here. I can simply go and to my documents and say I have this PDF file with me. I'll bring it and drag and drop. But let me add one more so that I can explain it to you. And here is this time I am adding a Word document. So you can see there are two files, and let us save and return to our course. See, here it is showing only one, the PDF one. MS Word is not visible. So that is the difference. File means you can upload many files, but only one file which you add the first will become the primary file, and all other files later on they will be treated as secondary files. So if you want to change it, then you need to change their property to make them primary file, which should be visible here. In that case, it is always better to, if you want to show them multiple files, create a folder. So you add, create a folder. You give the name here, a folder like plant, and then here is the folder, and within one folder you can have subfolders. Say like for question papers, the main folder name is question paper, then one folder for 2019, another folder for 2018, third folder for 2017, and like that so many folders. And here you can now again bring, so here is your MS Word, I added that. Now let me add the PDF, and here is my PDF, and I added them. Let me just save. So you can see here the folder is there, and if I click on plant, it will show me all the files which I have added there. So that way I can either click on a single one and I can download the folder as well. Remember that. If you click on it, it will be downloaded. It won't open there because the software is at the, if you have to display something there on the screen, it is better to create it as a page in which the text is there, and that can be displayed directly on the mobile screen of the students as well. So that way. Then comes the book feature. This I like this book feature very much. This is a book, something like a book is this one book, but here if I have a PDF of this book and I upload it, it will become file because file is one document. But here it is a clickable page by page file. So I click on, say I name this resource as plant, and then its appearance, how it will look like, activity completion, and simply I will click and save it. Now it is asking me to add chapters into my book. So my first chapter is STEM, and its content, all the plants have a stem. And then if you want, you can add image. You can simply say go back here and you can add some photograph. So I added that, and then you can save changes. So this has become, so this is, and here you can see one. This is my table of contents. Now I will click on plus and a new chapter will be added. So the next chapter is root and some roots bring food from earth to upper parts of plant, whatever you want to write. Again, you can add all these things. You can make the text bold. You can make the text italics. You can make it a bulleted point, and you can format its heading like that way. You can change it with so many editing features and save changes. So see, now there are two chapters. And then you can add third chapter, and in third chapter we will have flower, but I want this to be a sub chapter. So if you make it sub chapter, that flowers have pollen grains. Okay, and I'm just taking some text and save changes. So see here, because it is a subchapter, it has been named as 2.1. If I make it simple, then it will be chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, like that. And let's go back and see how it looks like. So this is the book. You can see here, like a book. You click on this book, and then from here, you can click on any content from this side, and it will open. And a book can similarly include text, image, audio, video, anything, including a web page, the web URL. And you can navigate either from table of content this side, or here is this forward arrow key, either here or here, or you can, so you click on it and it will take you to the next chapter. Now you can go back, go forward. The navigation from any side is possible. So the advantage of the book is that if you have common information about one topic, it is better to create a book, because then the students, they can navigate it very easily from there. So these are the things which we add as resources for our students. And now let me come to the activities where the students, they have to do something for them. One of the important thing here to be done by them is the discussion forum. So we add a forum. Now the difference between a discussion forum and announcement is that announcement is one way. The announcement is by default, it comes in your Moodle course, in the top of the page, in the top of your course. Announcements are for the teacher to make certain announcement related to the teacher, related to the course. That is from teacher to all the students, it goes. And if your system, you have made the configuration in such a way, then an confirmatory email goes, or here in the upper top, the notification area, it will show you as in Facebook, you get that red notification, it comes there. So here, what are functions of STEM? This is the question. Here you can say, please explain in 30 words there, and then standard, if you want, the students, they can attach, make some attachment. Otherwise you can, so how many attachments they can make, 1, 2, 3, you can decide. And this is subscription is important. If you make it forced subscription, so whenever anyone, either teacher or students, do anything, an email will go to all the students registered in your course. That is good as a teacher. If you are discussing some important topic and you may feel that student is not coming to the website, then let an email go to them. And similarly, read tracking. Read tracking means it allows you that whether the student, they have seen this post or not. So it is whether optional or off, that can go there. And similarly, you can click on save and display. So this has become, as a teacher, what are the functions of STEM? Please explain in 30 words. And the, when the students, they will see, they will click on add a new discussion topic, and it will come here. And then they can write sport, and here they can write that the STEM sports other parts of plant, whatever you need to think, you can add something, you can allow them. And then there is an attachment that can also go, and click on it. So that way it gives you 30 minutes.
Yeah, it's good
to edit it. Otherwise, now the students, then they will go. If you change your role to student, so as a student, when you see it, you click on it. You see, you will see that the student there, and then you can use this reply function. And then type your reply, here and save it. So this is the, now you can see it has become a threaded discussion. So the first, and see here, this is little bit inside to the right. So you can, from here you can see that which is related to what. And here is the permanent link. This is very good in case you want to connect some discussion somewhere in the Moodle at some other place. So that way you can link, you can make a link of it. Show parent means which is the parent discussion point, and that if it goes very, very long and you want to see what was the parent point, you click on it and it will bring you to the parent discussion point from there. And that way this is discussion for me. So this is there, and then I have to change my role because this is student role. I come back to my normal role and turn editing on. So it has come. Now there are two important things for us here. One is assignment and another is quiz. Assignment is like your essay type assignment, essay type question. You can add that. So you click on add assignment. It will ask you to add assignment, assignment name, say like plant, and here is the discussion. It telling you that please explain in 200 words the process of pollination and upload your assignment. Please don't go into the spelling mistakes. And then if you want to add something, these are the important things. Now the assignment, when it starts accepting, what is the due date, you can change them, you can make them. And particularly in our university, we have conducted the examination as the final examination, online examination. The question is available to you at 10 o'clock, and at 12 o'clock we fix it here and it will close. After that, if I fix it on this date and this particular time, it won't be available. So that way you can do it. Now how the students will submit, you can make them as a file upload, as submission file, or inline text. That way, if it is inline text, then you can tell them that, tell the software that won't accept more than 300 words. That is the limit here for online text. And if they are uploading the files, how many files they can upload, maximum size, at present it is 100 MB, I'll make it 200, and I can accept it file types here, PDF, PPT, Word document, Excel sheet, what I can fix. Then another necessary thing for us to decide is feedback type. As a teacher, what, how do we provide the feedback? As the feedback comments online or as the feedback file upload? We download the assignment of the student, make our comments on that, and upload it back from there. And then submission settings, these grades is important. We need to give that it is the, how much that assignment is, say like 10 marks, 20, 50, 30, and what is the minimum grade to pass it. If it is 10, 5 marks there. And this way we come and click save and display. There is some issue with the page. So that way, and you here you can see that the assignment will come, and then the students, they can, it has taken us into that area. So that way it is asking us to type into it. And this is there, can my student note my the teacher in the Moodle, sir? If it is during discussion forum, that can be visible. Otherwise in assignments or quiz, it won't be visible. So that way. Now let us see how we can create an assignment now. And here is the grade book we see what are the our activities which we have given, and then course total is here. This is for the first assignment, this is for the second assignment. The students, when you give them their marks, the marks will be visible here. The good point here is that you can export that grade sheet as Excel sheet, plain text, XML file, and give it to your university to let them process that. And then here are the letters which you can fix depending on your evaluation process mechanism, that if it is A grade, what is there, A minus, B plus, and you can edit and you can change them from here by making them, and then these will be available. You can make it say 93, 94, and accordingly you can change them to all for there. So this is a very strong, and not only that, you can make it competency based means the course in which you can add competency, that whether the students will be able to, you know, analyze, critical analysis, collaborate, those kind of competencies you can define from here, and you need to create and add it into your first there, and the assessment will be based on those competencies in that case. Now before the time closes, I want to show you quiz also. So for quiz, you click on add quiz and then add. There you can give the name of the quiz, say plant, and then about its timings, when it will be available. And here is an interesting thing about the time limit. If you think that your quiz has 10 minutes, 10 questions, so you can tell the students 15 minutes, give them and save it. So what will happen, that this quiz is available from this time to this time, open this quiz at this time by enabling it and closing this. So here I can close this at 5 o'clock. So now it is 5 o'clock, it will open, 6 o'clock it will close. But within that, once a student starts attempting it, they have to complete it within 15 minutes. So within 1 hour, the quiz will be available. But as soon as you start doing it, if you are not able to answer all your questions within 15 minutes, your quiz will be submitted to the system, whatever the left or there. And here, then if you want to give them some grace period, in this case, because you have enabled them, not there, then you can award the grade. Means out of 10, 5 is the passing grade. Unlimited attempts, or how many attempts you want the students to go for, one attempt only, or if you want to make them unlimited, in that case what will be the grade you would like to have, pehli bar jab kiya tha wo, aakhri bar kiya tha wo, ya average of the marks, ya highest mark, jitne bhi attempt kiye, whatever he gets from there. Layout means how the questions will appear, all the questions on one page, or one question on one page, two question on one page, and like that. Question behavior, this is very important for you. Shuffle within the questions, keep it yes, so that if 10 students are appearing, it question 1 will be question 3 for someone else, question 5 for someone else, and then A, B, C, D, those four options, they will also be shuffling. Suppose if I create a question that name the capital of Nepal, so for someone it will show Lalitpur, some for someone it may show Kathmandu, for someone it may show something else, and like that you can control those functions so that the student, they don't do cheating. Okay, there is some issue with the portal as of now, so in that case then you can we can create our quiz, and it asks us what kind of, there are many types of quizzes available, multiple choice, matching type, mathematical type of quizzes, etc. Just like Dr. Parveen showed you, there are so many large variety of questions available which you can do. I think, let me see, I have the ready made quiz available in some of my course. Okay, here is this virus quiz. So you can see no more attempt because already then attempt has been taken and the time limit was 15 minutes and submitted 23rd April. Here we can review. And then say this way the question will appear, the answers and the correct answer, the wrong answer it will say. And then from here you can see and you can provide the feedback and then the, how much the analysis of the question, that how many were answered, were incorrect, were correct, or that way you can go ahead by having it. So these are some of the important functions available. Let me just display you some course, that how our faculty members, they have been making good use of these features of the Moodle. And let me go to the site home and search for a course. Say this course. So this is a course on sociological imagination. This is the information. This is the name of the teacher. And we will go inside the course. This is the course here, course announcement, get to know each other, learning outcomes, then the file. Here is the web page. Then this is a wiki, learning together to collaboratively work on a particular thing. Then these are the resources. The PDF file has been given, a feedback form for the students about this unit, feedback about first unit. Then similarly, feedback about second unit, and we have information here. There is the audio message. If you click it, so on the basis of that, this teacher is asking the student that listen to this podcast and then answer the questions here in this assignment. And this is a quiz, this enchantment and its intellectual trajectory. There, actually it is a live course, so the one attempt, the quiz was closed on this day. But from the grade book, you can see all the grades, they are, you know, on the basis of the students, then we can add them. So this way, these are various functions which are available, that we can make use of them in our course. Okay, so let me stop here, and if there are any questions, then we can answer them. Okay, let me. Okay. How can a student, Nayan Kumar is asking, how can a student see the notes made by a teacher on Moodle? There are various ways that a teacher can make notes. You can upload, okay, let me show it to you so that you can get a better idea. Here is the course which I created, and you can see here teacher notes. So you can add as a Word document, or you can make it as a page, and this will be visible if you use your mobile app. So that way your notes will be visible to the students. Okay, and then page, how can add, okay, this I have answered. how to customize Moodle. The Moodle customization can be done by the site administrator, and there are many features into it. Could you explain to develop lesson in Moodle? Yes, lesson is created. You select your either you want to have your lesson as a page or as a PDF document or as a book, which I showed to you. You add that, and then that will become a lesson in the Moodle. Means you just need to have your text, your images, your audio, video. You add them. It is always better to use a page, because when you save it, it will become your lesson. And Professor Gangaram Gautam is correct that it can be customized by the university administration. For that, you need to go to the site administration. Again, let me show you the page. This is the site administration. Here is the site administration. And in this, you see, here comes the front page settings. So whatever I write, say for example, at present you see in the top it is written RCSET, okay, and here it is. So if I write here like my name, Dr. Ramesh Sharma, at present here, so you pay attention to the upper left corner, RCSET, where it is written, it will change with my this name now. So I go back to the bottom and save changes. And see, the name has been changed. So this is front page setting. When the students, they reach your page, they will see all this information. Other than that, you need to be doing with appearance. So logo, you can add the university logo. What are the colors, calendar, blog, navigation, Moodle Docs, etc. All these things, you can add them here. But please remember that as a teacher, you won't be able to customize it. Only the administrator, because they have that flexibility. And that is for security purpose. Otherwise, if it is allowed to all the teachers, there will be so mismatch and the site can go wrong. That's why it is allowed only for the administrator to do that. And you can add so many plugins into it. Through that to make your Moodle more powerful. Okay, any other question? If you want to learn something, I'm creating a online training program on Moodle, on how to learn Moodle or learning Moodle. When it is completed, then I will send the message, and you can then join that class. It will be an online course on learning Moodle. And through that course, you will be knowing that how, like today I have given you this in real time, this demonstration, this session. But in that course, then you can go inside and learn from it. Then there is one question, how to customize the interface of Moodle. Okay, that is a good question. That is done through the themes. It is done through themes. You have to select a particular theme for your course. And here is the themes. If you can see, at present in this Moodle, I have three themes, the Boost theme, the Classical theme, and the Moodle Cloud, which is by default. Here is the theme selector, and I need to select the theme. What are available options with me? Say, like you can see, this is the Boost theme. Here the Moodle will look like this. This is the Classical theme if you use it, or Moodle Cloud. But there is another, my university in Malaysia, where I was teaching so far, where there we had Fordson. Let me see if I can show you Fordson theme for Moodle. That also looks quite good. This is that plugin directory. From here you can select the things, and here is the screenshots for that Fordson theme. Your course will appear like this, and this is how the home page would look like. So the answer to your question is that you need to select the right kind of theme for your website. Okay. You can get a copy. Yes, I will post the recording. The recording has been done, and once it is there, I will upload it on YouTube and send the link to Professor Gautam, who can share it with all of you. And if you want to, I'm typing my email ID here. This is my email ID, which I have just typed for everyone who you know. You can write to me. Can we place our own page in the interface? Yes, you can do it. Can we use it for free? No, this question I didn't understand. Can we use it for free of cost? Means what you are using for free of cost. This Moodle Cloud is free of cost, which you can use. Otherwise, there is another website which you can create Moodle free of cost for you, is Genomeo. This is the website which you can use, and here in one course you can add 250 students. This is free website, and it can give you about around here you can see 10 GB disk space, around 1000 active users there, and that you can Dr. Parveen has posted the link. You can click on it and create your own account. You can think of a good catchy name, say like, for example, this is the name for my website, egurukul.com, and here are these courses. This is the name egurukul. Let me paste it here, and maybe Dr. Parveen can also paste a link for his. You can think, it can be your name also. Like here, if you see my this Moodle Cloud theme, I can and I have created this website with my own name, Ramesh Sharma moodlecloud.com. So it depends on your own choice that how you would like to proceed. Okay, so Kiranji, if you can make your question clear to me, then I can reply about free of cost. If you wanted to know about the platform, these two platforms, they are free of cost. Otherwise, ask your institution to download the Moodle and install it on university servers. In that case, you won't have any limitation of disk space, number of courses, and so many other things. Thank you, Dr. Ruma. Thank you so much. So, any other questions? Otherwise, I will request Professor Gangaram to conclude. And before we conclude, let me repeat it again. How many of us are present at now? 36. Maybe I can request them that now you can, general page.
Turn on your video.
You can turn on your video so that we can take a photograph, group photograph for everyone. And on your screen, you will find a setting for thumbnails. On your screen, on the top, you will find how to arrange. And there you can select that how the video would be visible.
Video is not currently available. Okay. So how do we set up the gallery view?
Yeah, you go into the view.
The view, yes.
And then you will see all these our windows, they have been, arranged in a different way. And there may be more. So on one page, we can have around 30 participants. So you need to go to the page 2 to see rest of our colleagues.
Okay.
I can see some of our friends, they are on page 2. Can you take the photograph with your camera, please?
Yes, sir. I'm taking the screenshots. Some of our friends have not switched on the video, though.
Yeah, I can request Tilak Pandey. I can see Devender, Khada, Khadka. See who are there.
Yes, I can see the first screen full. Tilak Pandey ji has not started the video, though. Others have started. So I've taken the screenshot for the first one.
You all also can take those who are using it on your laptop. You can use your camera phone and take a photo of the screen. Yeah, this page is good because all are, except Parveen's own photo, everybody is here on this page. I will also save.
With the laptop, I'm looking at the mobile phone.
Yes.
Okay, so friends, you can take pictures. So thank you, Dr. Sarma, for your time and your generosity to help Nepal at this at the time of this crisis. Vice Chancellor of Open University had another meeting, so he had to leave a little earlier. So he has given his warm regards to you and sincere thanks for all your insightful sharing at this moment. And also, can you hear me, Dr.
Yes,
Sarma?
Yes. Yeah, you are visible.
All
yes.
Right. Yeah. Right. And also, as you mentioned in the beginning, that Trivandrum University is planning not just to make interim an arrangement of online program, but also extended it beyond COVID-19 in a blended mode of education. So we'll be going online for so many courses which are possible in a more kind of blended mode, so that we can provide access to quality higher education to the people who cannot come and join our face-to-face program. So this is not just crisis management initiative, it's more of long-term online or alternative mode of delivering higher education at Trivandrum University. So I think we will, this is just the beginning, we'll stay in touch, and then we'll expect you to collaborate with us in the future as well. And we will, of course, we look forward to receiving your YouTube video kind of self tutorial to install and design courses on the Moodle platform. So we'll continue our communication and collaboration in the future. With that, on behalf of Trivandrum University and also Open University Vice Chancellor, we thank you very much for you and your team for this insightful presentation and the session that you facilitated. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you. I will just say one last point that I'm not sure that how, because when one of our requirement is also to create our e-lectures and how you right. are recording your lectures. So there are certain screen recording facilities, and we can use Zoom, we can use Skype, we can use WebEx to record our lesson, in which we can have our photo plus the presentation and save it as a recorded video lecture. So just please let me know that if you would like to learn that how we can record our video lectures, maybe somewhere in next week sometimes when all of you are available, we can have one more session on interactive activities creating through H5P, through script casting here, and if how to create quizzes into the Moodle learning management system, because everything remains within the same system. So with this final word, thank you so much. I also thank you,
and
Professor Sharma and Bhandaji.
And also in Nepal Open University and in Trivandrum University, we have some experts who use Moodle, who has been using Moodle, So colleagues from Nepal, if you need any additional support and help, we will also be happy to locally run this kind of online session on the use of Moodles. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank all participants also.
Okay, everyone, take care and stay safe. Thank you so much. Namaskar.
You too. Namaskar.
Okay. Bye bye. I'll keep this window for a few more minutes so that it goes into the recording. And then you can leave the meeting from by the, there's a pointer, the red button in the corner of your screen.
Okay. Right.
Take care. Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.
Namaskar, sir. Namaskar. Okay, everyone is leaving.
Catherine, chat kya hai? Thank you to koi dil lagati hai. करता से पढ़ते
ओके थैंक यू बहुदा जी थैंक यू सो मच नाउ आई एम क्लोजिंग इट सो दैट आई कैन सेव द रिकॉर्डिंग एंड द चैट ओके बाय
बाय